GenePattern 3.8.0 debuted an updated user interface and a number of new features, such as the support for pinning modules, the ability to place a pipeline in multiple categories, the creation of dynamically populated dropdowns and modules, and file purge settings based on user or group ID, to name a few. We will review these and other features in this video overview of GenePattern 3.8.0. In GenePattern 3.8.0, we have, perhaps most obviously, redesigned the Modules and Pipelines panel and combined it with the recent Jobs Uploads panel so that all tabs for Modules, Jobs, and Files, to include any genome space associations, now appear only on the left hand of the GenePattern server page. You will notice that the full list of modules is no longer shown along the left side of the screen. In order to browse Modules and Pipelines, simply click the Browse Modules button. This then displays a sliding panel where you may choose to browse modules by category, by suite, or display the full list of modules. In each case, the ordering is alphabetical. Searching for modules in GenePattern 3.8.0 is much the same as it was in 3.7.0. Typing in the search box will begin to filter for modules and pipelines that match what you have entered. However, in 3.8.0, this is no longer limited to simply the module name. We can now search over the module name, description, and any suites or categories that are associated with the modules and pipelines, thus allowing you to more easily find a module, even if you are unsure of its name, but do know what function you seek. A new feature in 3.8.0 is the ability to pin a module or pipeline to the left-hand panel. To accomplish this, you simply search or browse for a module or pipeline, and then drag the desired object into the Favorite Modules area on the left. The gear icons displayed in the upper right of the module or pipeline provides a link to the documentation. As previously mentioned, one of the more obvious updates to 3.8.0 is the consolidation of the Modules and Pipelines panel with the recent Jobs, Uploads, and Genome Space panel. These are now located on the left, but continue to display the same information as before when the tab is selected. Note also that recently used modules are still displayed at the bottom of the Modules and Pipelines panel when the Modules tab is selected. Moving on to the Run Task form, we find an improvement in our support for running batch jobs. After checking the Batch box in the upper right corner of the desired parameter, you can drag in files or directories to create your list of files for the batch job. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, we've added the ability to give multiple categories to a pipeline, thus allowing it to appear in places other than under just the pipeline category. For instance, a pipeline could be given a functional category, such as RNA-seq, in addition to or instead of the pipeline category. For those users with module creation privileges, you may be happy to know that we now support the creation of dynamic drop-down lists, where the elements in the list refer to directories rather than only to files. When selected, the entire contents of the directory will be uploaded to the GenePattern server. This benefits modules whose dropdowns required multiple files to be retrieved, such as BWA or Top Hat. For those of you using these modules, it means you will have more timely access to data you've requested be added to these sorts of dropdown file lists, as the module developers only need add a file to a directory to have it appear, rather than release a whole new version of a module or pipeline. For those of you who are GenePattern administrators, we've now added the ability to set file purge intervals on a per-user and per-group basis, thus overriding the system-wide purge setting for those users and groups. Instructions for this can be found on the File Purge Settings page in the Administration section of the server UI. For those of you on our hosted server, please contact us if you think this might be of use to you. More information about these and other features, as well as bug fixes in GenePattern 3.8.0, can be found in our 3.8.0 release notes, available from the Help menu if you are on a GenePattern server, or from our website, genepattern.org, under Documentation/Tutorials in the menu on the left. More information about GenePattern can be found at genepattern.org. For notification of updates to our server, modules and pipelines, and other GenePattern news, please follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Google+, by searching for GenePattern, or by clicking on the links on our website.